The report covers black political attitudes in areas like Brent, but it's pessimistic about the increasing black prominence in politics. Brent has a 33% black population, the highest in London, with Haringey, Hackney, Newham and Ealing not far behind. Yet race issues locally and nationally tend to be kept off the main political agenda, dismissed as loony left and other labels. The head of Brent's race relations unit, himself an election candidate, is very much caught up in this dilemma. Are race issues being consigned to the political margins?
I think that there is some truth in that, and it's a bit of a shame that national politicians are not making as forthright statements on this question as they should, because the effect of that is that only black politicians talk about it.
The report goes on to say that racism is being resurrected, albeit covertly, as an election issue. Rows over Labour boroughs, often involving black councillors, and rows inside the Labour Party itself have made black politics an increasingly negative force.
The consequences, however, I think will be very serious, because I think that it will now be much too sensitive an issue for the parties to want to be seen to be associated with initiatives to promote racial equality, and that it, for the sake of short-term electoral gain, stirring up racism is going to result in further attacks on black people and a further alienation of black people who feel there is nowhere they can go with their political demands but onto the streets.
When people are dealing with this issue, we respect their rights and believe that we need to handle it sensitively. Yet it's constantly being referred to as the fair within the community, which I think is wrong.
Today's report concludes that the only way forward is for all parties to stand firm against the growing temptation to gain votes by pandering to racial prejudice. Susanna Greenberg in Brent for Thames News.